The Healthy Hunger Free Kids Act, aimed to bring down the calorie count in school lunches, is actually bringing up a lot of complaints among students. The war on obesity, which kills more Americans each year than cancer, is now being battled in public school cafeterias, and this food fight is getting personal. These federal guidelines were proposed by Michelle Obama in 2010, and were just put in place at the beginning of the 2012 school year. Students and teachers from Wallace County High School in Kansas have created the popular parody "We Are Hungry" in protest. Some of the more popular complaints among students have been the limited availability of high-sugar snacks and the smaller food portions. The new guidelines include only low-fat or fat-free milk, the assurance of fruits and vegetables every day, and calories limited to 650 for kindergarten through fifth graders, 700 for sixth through eighth graders, and 850 for high school students, which are the calories recommended by the Mayo Clinic. Although some people may deem these new codes necessary because the Center for Disease Control and Prevention states that 12.5 million of America's children ages 2 through 19 are obese, others consider them a violation of their children's Fifth and Ninth Amendments. The Fifth Amendment states that you cannot be deprived of life, liberty, or the pursuit of happiness without due process of law, and depending on interpretation and beliefs, childhood obesity can either be seen as a justified reason or not. In addition to the Fifth Amendment, the Ninth Amendment can present an issue for the parameters because it protects the rights of people that are not enumerated in the Constitution, which some might say is the right to choose what you put in your body. According to the U.S. Department of Agriculture Secretary Tom Vilsack, these new restrictions affect not only the lunch meals, but also the vending machines and a la carte menu items, and the legislation is even considering regulating what children can and cannot pack for lunch. Students here at Fort Mill have experienced the vending machine takeover because now instead of being able to purchase candy, their vending machines either have those items blocked or have replaced them with protein bars. Emmett Ballard, certified nutritionalist and trainer, agrees with the overall effect of trimming the fat.
In a perfect world, we should remove the unhealthy items.
While many experts like Emmett Ballard agree that the Ms. Obama's health plan is good for students, Roland Cambiding, student nutrition supervisor for Fort Mill High School District, thinks otherwise.
I believe students should have a choice of what they eat for lunch.
Fort Mill School District currently abides by the concept of offer versus serve, where students can choose 3 to 5 items from a 5-component offered meal, although this meal is now in line with the First Lady standards. I'm Graham Carter for PBS Student Reporting Labs.